Amid scenes of unforgettable splendor, Delhi celebrated the first anniversary of the Indian Republic. A huge concourse of people witnessed the president's ceremonial drive along Kingsway. The parade by the armed forces, at which Dr. Rajendra Prasad took the salute, was watched by a large and distinguished gathering. Earlier, the president presented 4 Paramveer Chakras for gallantry during the Jammu and Kashmir operation. 2 of them were awarded posthumously. Captain Ram Raghubarane was the proud recipient of the Paramveer Chakra, the highest award for gallantry. Havildar Karam Singh also received the Paramveer Chakra in person. After the presentation ceremony, units of the armed forces, headed by heavy tanks, marched past the saluting base. The smart turnout of the officers and men and their soldierly bearing won repeated applause from the jubilant crowd. Members of the Indian Navy followed the infantry units. After them came the representatives of the Indian Air Force, the youngest arm of the nation's defense services. They were followed by mechanized units of the Armored Corps. Mounted gun and other military vehicles trundled along the parade ground. The pomp and pageantry that was princely India added to the picturesqueness of the scene. There was a famous Jaipur horse, which has won laurels on many a battlefield. Here is the well-known Camel Corps from Jaisalmer. While the parade was in progress, more than 100 aircraft of the Indian Air Force zoomed past. Flying in formation, they dipped in salute to the accompaniment of cheers from the assembled crowd. Harvards, Dakotas, Liberators, Tempests, Spitfires, and jet planes participated in the bypass. The most interesting item of the celebrations was a tableau on mechanized floats, depicting famous episodes from Indian history. Celebrated figures whose valor, patriotism, and sagacity have contributed to India's greatness were brought back to life. Episodes from the immortal epics and historical events describing Indian heroism were vividly portrayed. Other events, which have become landmarks in India's annals, were realistically linked with the country's latest history. Later, the parade and the historical procession moved through the principal streets of the city. The entire route was lined by large crowds to see this splendid spectacle. The men of the defense services were greeted with cheers all the way. The pageant was organized by the Delhi Education Department. It was a day of rejoicing and of thanksgiving. It was also a day when pledges were renewed to strive for the greater glory of Republican India. Appealing to the nations of the world on the eve of the Republic Day celebrations, Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru said,
"I was in Europe at a critical time when the issues of war and peace hung in the balance. I endeavored to throw the whole weight of our country on the side of peace and a negotiated settlement of the conflict in the Far East. I have been intimately concerned with recent developments, and I have closely followed them. I am convinced that there is an overwhelming desire for peace all over the world, whether in the East or in the West. My visit to Western countries has convinced me of this. I would appeal to the great nations of the West, who are the repositories of that magnificent culture which we have admired, and whose astonishing scientific and technical achievements have opened out a new era for mankind, to cross this door of opportunity in search of peace. To the nations of Asia, I can speak perhaps in an even more intimate language and express the fervent hope that they will stand by the methods of peace, whatever happens. Jai Hind.